What can be better in a rainy day than to visit an art gallery? The place I have come today is known as Gallery Art Pieces, a gallery which showcases as well as sells art pieces made of clay along with many other unique items. In this episode of ours, we are going to witness how an art and craft society has transformed crafts making into a new level altogether, and that too with a social cause. One will be amazed to see how the traditional craft of pottery can attain a new benchmark through plush designing. Hello and welcome to yet another episode of Crafting Lives. Today my journey has brought me to a place called Palpara. You know, you are surrounded in a culturally rich place when each and every nook and corner of that place boasts of some or the other forms of handicrafts. The first thing today I'm going to see is an art gallery in front of me, and it boasts of really a lot of collection. So come join me in my journey. This art gallery is a must visit for tourists who come to Tripura, as it is one of its kind. For art lovers of Agartala, it is a place which they have adored. Located at Palpara in the Nuwabadi village, the place is just outside the capital city of Agartala. As soon as one enters the place, the visual treat begins. Every nook and corner of the place is decorated with art pieces of clay or metals or waste tools. You will definitely be thrilled to see how mundane things come alive with the Midas touch of art. The gallery is unique in its architecture and its collections. One could have never believed that clay crafts can be so exclusive in their design and themes. They portray a fusion of modern design in long lost traditional themes. What strikes me most is the rooftop, which is made of reinforced concrete, is in the shape of a mango tree along with real mango leaves, which gives the space a natural feel. The art pieces in the gallery are unique, not only for their design but also for the way they have been showcased. These artifacts are really captivating. But the best part in the gallery is that every item here is simple, yet unusual in a way. The face masks, either made of waste woods or clay, have their signature expressions. The gallery has successfully transformed folk tales into art pieces, which can add a new definition to interior designing. The walls of the gallery, along with the way it has been lit up, will definitely sway the visitor's mind. The Gallery Art Pieces showroom is a homage to the confluence of various cultures which the land of Tripura upholds. These dolls are traditional toys of erstwhile East Bengal, which have been used to portray the unique culture of the ethnic tribes present in Tripura. Just as they say, fashion follows trend and style follows art, the signature style of pottery in display here has made me fall in love with this place. The beautiful wind chimes and the greenery amidst the light deluge has already made my day. The entire space of the gallery is a bliss for an art lover. The verandas have beautiful wooden sculpture as well as clay murals, which has given the place a signature flavor. Each and every item used here for decoration is placed with some creative purpose. Gallery Art Pieces was established lately in the year 2013, and it is managed by Chitrarpita Art and Craft Society, registered in the year 2003. With an aim to create an ideal art village, first of its kind in the country, the society has professional artists and many creative souls who are working to create visually appealing environment for the village Palpara. The gallery has even a more beautiful studio along with it. Here, artisans are working to create modern designs for items both of utility and decorative purpose. Now we are going to see the pottery studio. But the way to the studio is also nicely designed. And this area is not far from the nature. It has been taken care along with the bamboo plants that we can see. Right here also is a mini pond that we have. Now zoom in and you can see this is actually not a pond, but it has been designed in such a way with the lotus flower that seems like a mini pond, and definitely it is going to attract your attention when you are going to visit this gallery. The art gallery is open to any creative inputs from artists, and they even are inviting artists to work alongside them. Coming to this art gallery has been a revisit to the childhood when floors and staircases made of mud were very common in the villages. Right now, I've reached the studio for the pottery section. I can see this beautiful piece of work. You can see these are the wood carving structures. This is a male model and this is a female model. So these two make a couple. And then we have the inner structure wherein I can see first the tribal women folk. And this is very typical. Their attire and their holdings are very typical for the state of Tripura. This is just depicting a wheel structure. And right here we have different facial expressions and the masks. Now this is again a total work terracotta. Coming here I can see some mural tiles, and this is still very wet, and so the work is still on in the studio. Coming to this, I can see this typical again for the state of Tripura. This is the Hojagari dance. And these people in real are really world famous, and they toured the whole world doing this, practicing this kind of the dance form. And so they have tried to create a replica in the form of terracotta. The ladies doing, practicing the Hojagari dance.
These life-size horses are some of the exclusive large structures the workshop has created. There, I found a couple of women working with clay crafts. I instantly took the opportunity to try my hands in it. It's like a rendezvous with your childhood. As kids, I'm sure that just like me, everyone must have played with such items of clay. Here, they have upgraded the design, giving it some cartoon feel so that today's children will find them attractive. Each and every item the artisans are working with are different yet similar to the traditional crafts. In the times when the traditional crafts are long lost amidst the high-end toys, the art society is in an attempt of reviving them with their attractive yet careful alterations.
In the studio, I have met these two ladies and who are busy with their art and craft. Right here, I can see a model of theirs, and they told me this is pretty new model. And you can see this is in Bengali known as putul. And so this is the women, and here are two kids who are going with her riding this big elephant. And this is very, very famous doll that is famous in the state of Tripura. And in our childhood, we'll find that maximum of the people in this state have really played with this kind of a doll. So this is a new structure that they have designed.
What are you making? Can I make it also?
Yes, it's the elephant's trunk.
Oh, acha, hati shoot. Erokom. Just erokom roll
korte hobe. Like this?
Yes.
Tarpor?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Aro?
Are we going to do it like
yes,
this?
Yes, like this.
Okay, okay.
No, no, Aro, do it again.
Now should I roll?
Like this.
Okay.
এই জায়গাটা কিছু হবে না, ফাইন্ডিং ইট ডিফিকাল্ট টু হোল্ড ইট প্রপারলি। ও আচ্ছা আচ্ছা, ওকে। সো দ্য এলিফ্যান্ট ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি ফেসিং টুয়ার্ডস মি।
No, no, no.
We have to roll more, right?
This will go up.
From here?
It will be joined with clay.
Just have to fix it like this?
Yes. It's from the soil only.
Does it need any processing?
Yes.
Do you have to prepare it the day before?
Yes.
No, it's not sticking to my finger. It's very beautiful. Is it done? Like this?
This makes 2 ears of the elephant.
Now, it's time to carve the eyes.
This is the seat.
Okay, okay. Should I put it like this?
Yes, clay.
Now should I put?
Yes.
So here goes the seed.
The doll is made. Wow.
Oh, I don't like it. Here goes the first baby. আরো চাবো, দে হ্যাভ এ পার্টিকুলার ডাইস ফর মেকিং দিস ডলস, অ্যাজ ইউ ক্যান সি দের ইজ এন ইনবিল্ট স্ট্রাকচার অ্যান্ড সো ওয়েন দ্য মড রোল গোজ ইনসাইড ইট অটোমেটিক্যালি টেকস দ্য শেপ অফ দিস ডাইস। সো লট অফ ওয়ার্ক ইজ লেফট আফটার ইট কামস আউট ফ্রম দি ডাইস, শি ইজ পুটিং দি বান অ্যান্ড অলসো মেকিং ইট লিটল ফ্যাটার and round shape. And here goes the mother, and our full structure is ready. Oh, it's trying to fall off. Really enriching experience, because for the first time, you know, in this journey, I have really learned to make something with mud, and you know, the creation is in front of you. Also, not only she has helped me a lot, but also I have done something for it. Thank you.
Coming here has been a real good experience as of now. As I approached the lowest floor of the place, I got to look at crafts more closely. The potter's wheel, one of mankind's ancient inventions, is present here, and I got quite excited seeing it. It feels like getting back to your roots. This open gallery is meant for large structures, and like other parts, this place is also well decorated and well maintained. The volume of concentration and labor needed for making these crafts make them so beautiful. Walking through gallery, I came across the co-owner of this place.
How are you?
I'm fine.
So will you tell me what is going on in the studio?
Actually, the studio is run by the society, and we work here as an artist, as an entrepreneur. So here every day we try to create new things. Our whole day gets spent in creating new things. We want to work the colorful culture of Tripura. This village is named as Palpara, where the families are mostly potters. Whatever they are doing, if we can modernize a bit or bring more perfections to those designs, then it may end up being a world art. This is what we're trying to do.
So you're involving everyone in this project?
Yes, almost. The artisans who work here with us, mostly women, are from this village only. They used to do pottery before, but have left the profession in recent times. We are trying to bring them back and help them to have a sustainable livelihood from modern clay craft.
So that they get more financial stability?
Yes, and continue doing their crafts.
So, my friends, I think you have heard that right. All the artisans who are listening to me are really welcome to this studio. She is telling that anyone who is interested to work in this studio is absolutely welcome.
The crafts we are making here are highly indebted to Tripuri culture. The tribal culture of Tripura and the East Bengali culture of Bangladesh, as all the Bengalis who live here basically have their roots in Bangladesh, erstwhile East Bengal.
Yes, almost everyone.
So that culture is also present in us. We are trying to modernize our crafts while mixing these two different yet coherent cultures, both folk and tribal.
That's nice. I won't waste your time anymore. Carry on. From there, I went to see the warehouse of the gallery.
Now I have reached a spot. This is mainly the storeroom or the workstation for them. You know, this kind of a thing that I can see in front of me is basically called the mural tiles. The Kumar people, the Kumar caste people of this state, were initially involved with the terracotta work. But with time, you know, with many constraints, these things got obsolete, because the roof tiles and the flowers got really instinct. Now is the time that they have really come up with a new version of terracotta, and that to say, these are the mural tiles that you can see in front of me. Very nicely designed, and these are going to be colored and going to be put on the wall of different walls of the streets or elsewhere. And this is how they are going to survive the time.
The warehouse stores wonders within itself. The different items along with the cases which make them are really beautiful. All these artifacts are yet to reach their final stage, as they have to be forged in fire, which will make them hard enough. These unique items are still awaiting their completion, after which they'll be on display in the gallery. Some of them are already completed and are just being stored here.
Is their main storeroom, and these are the things that we can see. This is a part of pottery. Like in pottery, a typical part is the terracotta section. So here we can find the different designs, this one mainly being a Ganpati Bappa, but this is not a finished product. Here it comes for storing, and then later on it goes for firing. After firing, this every piece that we see here will get its typical color that we usually see, the terracotta color. One thing that I have learned after visiting this store is that there is a huge collection of different designer items. This one, you can see, it's a small face, a small piece of wonder in terracotta. This is a pot. Now you can see, this is a utility product. This is going to be used, like in Bengal, we'll usually find this for storing rasagullas. So pottery has two sections basically. One is for the utility, and the second one is just for show. So here what the owner says is that he's trying to mix both the things, so that there is utility as well as there is design. So that's the artwork of this particular art gallery. And work of art cannot really be known without the artist. So let me introduce you today to the artist of this particular gallery, Mr. Mantosh Devnath. Hello sir, welcome to the show.
Coming here today has been a nice experience for me. I want to know about your journey regarding this gallery.
The gallery started off on 21st February 2014. Making a gallery was not our primary aim, but it is for the people, our patrons, that we came up with a gallery. Before the gallery, the studio has come. When we started working in the studio, then people used to throng the place to have a look. For this enthusiast, we came up with a gallery, so that they can see our products, what we are making actually. We started our studio in 2006 in the name of Terracotta Institute. It was formed under a society named as Chitrarpita Art and Craft Society, which was established in 2003.
Is it a government initiative?
No, it says society under the Societies Registration Act.
What I would like to ask you more is that the ambience here is really beautiful. The gallery is also in the lap of nature, and it's pretty awesome. But why is it at outskirts of the city?
Yes, there are. Firstly, 10 years before, there was a crisis in Agartala that there is nowhere to go if one wishes to get out from the city. Despite of many government initiatives, there remained a lack. Why should artists like us go to the cities for our art? Rather, we should be in villages, as art happens in villages. City is just the market of the artifact, but handicrafts is actually practiced in the villages.
Here I saw terracotta works in your gallery. Also, there are wood carvings from waste tools. But when I look into your brochure, I found out that you work in artifacts made of waste products and even textiles. So tell us something about that.
Well, we artists look for art everywhere. If we can come up with an artifact from the waste, then it will be a recreation and recycling as well. We have tried to work on that. Presently, we are working with wood waste for scrap materials. We have done installation in Agartala ONGC campus.
So is it a specific type of waste? As there are many different sort of wastes.
We created from the wastes available in the ONGC, and their waste machineries and all. Many are displayed inside the ONGC campus.
What are your dreams?
We, as well as our society, has been trying for a few years to come up with a model craft village. During the season time, which is November, December, we have planned to come up with a village art fair. And also we are trying to move on from the low temperature terracotta to high temperature ceramics. This is also a priority for us this year.
Terracotta to ceramics.
It was very nice experience talking to you.
Frankly speaking, you know, I have been through this journey of crafting lives for quite a some time, but I have not seen an artist of his stature, and definitely I can tell you frankly that you are one of a kind, and he is managing this art gallery so nicely, financially viable gallery. So definitely standing at this point, you can be an idol for a lot of young artisans sitting out there and watching us.
By this time, the visitors have already started coming in. If you want a break from the city life, a short trip to this art gallery is the best.
Right in the center of this particular gallery, we have a mango tree like structure. You know, in the first look, it seemed to me like a real mango tree.
Is this a real mango tree?
No, it is an RCC structure. We have attached real mango leaves in the tree structure. Our gallery is in the village. In order to have that feel, we have put up this structure. So it is like an open sky, along with the different items of the village life.
The leaves are real?
Yes, natural mango leaves.
Natural. So it's a combo of basically a RCC structure which is man-made and some dried natural mango leaves that we can see at the rooftop. So really nice, really amazing ambience that I can see here.
Here I can see a beautiful structure. Is it a showpiece?
Yes, it is a sculpture.
Made of?
It is made from fiberglass. It depicts that a child wants to give wings to his dreams, but he is not able to do it because of poverty and societal oppression. This happens to our children in the villages. They try to achieve a lot, but their circumstances doesn't allow them.
He is just wrapping some cloth.
I'm seeing a lot of things here. What is this craft?
It is actually a hookah, but with a unique style.
Okay. The whole thing is a hookah, and it is a face-like structure which is also smoking a hookah.
Yes.
Are these natural colors?
Actually, we use two types of clay here. One is white clay, while the other one is red. So the color comes naturally.
And this one?
The black one is artificial.
I'm finding everything interesting here. So what is this?
This is a miniature sculpture of the Unakoti relics of Tripura. We have made it for the tourists so that they can keep it as their memories of the visit to Tripura.
Wow, Very nice. So let's see something more. There are so many. What are these?
From waste woods, we are making all hanging masks. The wood which is useless, thrown away. We take them and utilize it for artistic creation.
So is it for couples here?
Yes. Here there is a small item which is called as the sack game. We used to play with granary sacks in our childhoods, like hide and seek. This joy has been recreated here. It was designed during our training seasons. It has been designed by the artisans then.
Okay, actually each and every item in your gallery is very beautiful. So is this a sculpture?
Yes, this definitely is a sculpture, and secondly it is a traditional form of Tripura.
What does it depict? Is it a tribal lady?
Yes, it shows a tribal lady of Tripura, and she has a traditional tribal item, the basket called as khara. Here is a Durga idol, different from the form we are used to see. It is made from a red clay.
What does this depict?
This is a family, a normal family who are selling dreams. That is why they are having birds on the shoulders, heads, everywhere. With this they are trying to fly in order to achieve their dreams. It is just a dream that they have.
So more like your own family, right? Acha. Thik ache. So what is this?
This is a crisis composition.
Can you please lift it up?
Yes, it portrays water crisis. This is unique piece for the center table. If we look at from above the eye level, then we will be curious that what are all these people over here are looking at. There is a curiosity in them.
Is it a well structure where the water level is very low?
Yes, it is the search for water.
Okay, what does this piece signify?
It is a recreation of fairy tales. There was a tale that in my maternal house there is such a big pan that everybody in the village can come and actually take bath in it. We have tried to create that. It's for the center table.
Obviously this item is not for sale, but it looks very interesting. What does it imply?
Actually, in our development as artists, we have been hugely influenced by Bester's tribal artifacts. It has formed this gallery in the village. Influence as in we were trained in crafts there, and we used to roam around in villages, work with the local artisans. Their crafts have influenced our work a lot. We learned how the villagers work, how to work with them. So this is our route. Whatever we do, we should not forget our route, which is this.
The interesting thing is that the 3D structure and ornaments.
Yes, yes.
Actually, each and every piece of this art gallery is noticeable and very, very unique in its own form. So I cannot really find out and pinpoint on one object that this is the best one. Every work of yours is superb. Thank you. Today, my journey to this art gallery has come to an end, but I'm going to cherish the memories forever. And if you're looking for something like a weekend trip, come right here.